Hey everybody, it's Marshall Monkey here. This is going to be my Girl Meets World, I don't even know what episode we're on. Season 2, I think it's episode 20, no, actually, I think it's episode 30, really. There's so many episodes this season, I think that Disney's really pushing the limit on how many episodes they should have. Case Undercover had about 29 episodes. For me, the episode numbers were different because I put the two-parter episodes for Case Undercover all in one bundle. But yeah, Disney's really pushing it on how many numbers they need for episodes. I feel like they should only have at least 23 episodes, 21 to 23 episodes. They are pushing it to 31 episodes. Like, that's probably how many episodes Girl Meets World's gonna have. Hopefully it ends, season 2 ends soon. Girl Meets World season 3 is apparently going to be a really big thing, which is exciting. But, you know, I guess more episodes means more reviews from me to you, so yeah, there we go. This episode was a very interesting episode. I didn't feel like it was the best episode of the season. I feel like we've had way better episodes in terms of guest stars, people returning from the original series, from Boy Meets World. I didn't think this one was super great, and here's why. I think that Girl Meets World is worried about how many life stories they have to fit into one season, which is why I think they should kind of minimize how many episodes they put in a season. Sorry if you can hear the cars and trucks out there, but anyway, yeah, I think they should minimize how many episodes they put in a season, because they're running out of ideas, and I think that's a really crazy thing. Now, when they get to high school in season 3, that's probably going to change, or they're probably going to get more ideas. And they're maybe even pushed the limit. They kind of did that with some of the episodes, like the religious episode this season. They kind of pushed the limits a little bit on that because people have different religions, different opinions. But when they get to high school, they're going to push the limit. Hopefully, not too much, but like in a Disney sort of way, like Disney kind of does sometimes, especially with that religious episode. But they're probably going to push the limit in season 3 when they get to high school. And hopefully everything changes for them as well in that one. But for now, they deal with the fact of communism in this episode, which is really cool. And they kind of use that as their storyline this episode. Every episode's a little bit different with, in terms of life lessons and history lessons. But this episode was cool because I felt like I was actually listening to a lecture from, Corey. I actually felt like I was listening to a lecture from him because it was such a teaching thing. Like, there wasn't much of too craziness going on in the gang's life. Like, it wasn't relationship stuff, and it wasn't everything. It was really basically focused on this matter, and there wasn't too much comedy, there wasn't too much. It was actually a really big learning episode, which is what I liked about it, because it was elegant that way. It wasn't like the other life lesson episodes, where it's just kind of too much, but then there's also a balance of comedy. It was kind of just an elegant, like, episode in terms of how it presented the storyline, which is what I like about it. But we get to this story because of the honor board. The honor board is basically the group of students. They have Yogi on there. They have the one blonde girl. I can't even remember what her name is. I think they had the other girl with the glasses, I think. I really need to learn these extras' names. Like, they need to give them names and actually give them a storyline so we can actually learn these characters. Because they seem, like, really interesting. They've had lines before, but I have no idea what their names are. Then we also have Lucas and Riley. No surprise there. They have to pair them up. But anyway, yeah, so let's talk about it. So Riley, of course, punishes Zay from being the Robin Lunch of the school. But then it seems like she gets a little thrown off guard when Maya and Farkle come in, because Maya and Farkle are the main people, of course. And I really want Zay to become a main character in season 3, like, have his credit in the song and have a bigger storyline, you know? That'd be really cool, because Zay is a big character of the season. He's kind of like the Farkle, the Corey Fogelman of season 1, which is what I really like about it. But anyway, going into this episode, struck the tripod a little bit, sorry guys. Going into this episode, Riley gets thrown off guard because of Maya and Farkle's decision to share answers, which I thought was really cool. But when you think about it, I actually was kind of on Riley's side a little bit, because if you're all learning the same things, it's kind of weird. I don't know. I don't really feel like that. I don't know. It's kind of weird to me because I'm kind of like homeschooled, so I guess I don't see it that way. But I've been to public school before. I've been there for a year, so I know. And it's kind of weird because, you know, it is cheating, and it is sharing at the same time. It's kind of weird, but they did get in trouble for it, and I feel like that is cheating. Like, you want to learn it on your own, and you want to make sure that every student learns it, because if they don't learn it, what's the point? You know what I mean? You know, it's kind of weird, but it's harder to retain information as well, unless you do it in your own way, which that was what they were trying to explain between Maya and what was going on for the storyline, which I thought was really cool, too. But anyway, yeah, so they go through this whole communist story, and meanwhile, I'm going to talk about Augie too. Meanwhile, Augie and goes through this little story as well, from finding out who he wants to be. Didn't really think that this episode was really good with Augie's storyline. It was funny when he dressed up as Topanga and stuff like that. I didn't really think it was a big deal. We got to see Ava Morgan Stern, but she wasn't annoying like she usually is. I know that some of you that have commented that saying that she's annoying She's an annoying character to have. I don't agree. I think she's pretty much a smooth character when it comes to her guest starring. Not the best, but, you know. But anyway, we get to see his classroom, which is pretty cool. So we get to deal a little bit with Augie, but it's mostly about this communist storyline. In the end, they learn the meaning of communism, and they kind of, you know, split up to their individual, people, I guess you could say. But yeah, they learned their lesson, I guess you could say. I don't know. I'm just trying to describe it to you as I watched the episode. But it was a pretty good episode. Not the best of the season. I definitely think that it was pretty cool. Like I said, it wasn't too, you know, comedic when it came to the storyline. It was a really good, elegant episode with explaining this storyline. And it really felt like I was getting lectured by a teacher, which is really cool. It was like Ben Savage was lecturing me through the screen. It was pretty cool. What did you guys think of this episode? Don't forget to comment down below. Links out there to my other Girl Meets World episodes. Links in there to my Twitter, Instagram, Vine, Vlog channel, and Sims channel. Updates. Deadpool is tonight, so I'm going to be... Well, actually, it was yesterday, but I didn't want to see it yesterday because my brother wasn't here to take me. So we're going to see it tonight, and I'm going to post my review tomorrow before I leave town as well. And then I'm going to try to do that Captain America Civil War video that I haven't done since, like, forever. I'm going to try to do that, too. But anyway, thanks for watching this. Like this video. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.